Good evening.
Well, we thank everyone for coming out on this evening. Praise the Lord. Appreciate everyone pressing their way and ready to magnify the Lord. Hear the word, rejoice in Him, and give God all the praise. Hallelujah. So to ask you to stand with me, would you pray and believe God tonight and to do what He desires to do in the midst of us. We sure appreciate our guests and Pastor Scale coming and visit with us again. Always enjoyed him all down through the years. It's been a blessing to us. And thank God for seeing him and the people that accompany him once again. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you for this day and even this evening, Father. We thank you for this opportunity, Lord, to come into your house. Father God, amongst your people, to praise you, to magnify you, to worship you. Lord, to hear your word, to grow and be nourished and strengthened. We thank you, Father God, that you have your way and your purpose and your will be done in the name of Jesus. We thank you for your loving, kind, and tender mercy you continue to show forth to us, oh Father God. We just thank you, Father God, for even what you're going to do even on this night. That you be glorified, Lord God, that you be lifted up, you be magnified in the name of Jesus. We rejoice in you because you're such a good God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father God, for moving by your Spirit, touching the hearts, Lord God, healing, delivering, set free in the name of Jesus. We thank you for your word, Father God, falling on good ground, bringing forth, hallelujah, seed, hallelujah, in our hearts to bring forth that which you desire, Father God. In the name of Jesus, let your will be done, Lord. Hallelujah, in us and through us. You be lifted up, you be magnified. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. You said if Jesus be magnified, you shall be, hallelujah. Draw all men unto you, Father. We thank you, Father God. We give you the praise and the glory, Lord, through songs and worship. Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that you be lifted up, you be magnified, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. We give you the praise and the glory, Lord God, for all that you're doing. We thank you, Lord, for the one that is on their way. We give you the praise and the glory, Father God, for all that's going to take place even this night, Father God. We thank you, Lord God, for the blessing, hallelujah, that is on the way. We rejoice in you, for truly this is the day that you have made, and we shall rejoice in you. We will bless you, Lord. We will magnify you, Lord God. Hallelujah. But truly, you are awesome, God. We thank you, Father God, for who you are, for you are truly our Redeemer. We give you the praise and the glory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We bless your name, Lord. We glorify you, Lord God. We magnify you, Lord God. Thank you for having your way, Lord God. Thank you for being in this place even now, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we give you the praise and the glory, Lord God. Because you are awesome, God. Just wondrous things in us, O Lord, and through us on our behalf. We thank you, Father God, for tending to us for your mercy and your grace and your peace. We thank you for joy unspeakable, Lord God. In the name of Jesus, we shall rejoice in you in this night, Lord God. We shall lift our hand and praise you, Lord God. Because truly you are a good God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord God, for this opportunity, Lord God, to come to your praise, Lord God. We're rejoicing in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God. And we delight ourselves in you, Lord God. You should give us, oh Lord, and our things of our heart, Father God. We thank you, Father God. We just give you the praise and the glory, Lord. For meet every need according to your riches and glory through Christ Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And again we say we rejoice. We shall rejoice and be glad in you, oh Lord. We give you the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Well, praise God. We bring forth the praise and worship. Hallelujah. And let's just press in with a praise. I mean, don't allow the enemy to have it, you know, to try to shut us down and quiet us up. Hallelujah. Make in your heart that you will give God the praise, even if it's a sacrifice of praise. And through that, he'll come around and bless you even in the night. In the name of Jesus. Amen.
Glory to your name, Jesus. Come on, let's just begin to praise him. Hallelujah. Let's begin to make a joyful noise. Hallelujah unto the Lord. Hallelujah. For God is good. His mercy is everlasting. Hallelujah. And his truth endures for all generations. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. You're worthy, Lord, of all the praise, God. You're worthy of all the glory, God. You're worthy of all the honor, God. We love you, Lord, today, Jesus. We love you today, Lord. We love you today, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you.
glory, 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 yes. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We have the victory. Oh, in the name of Jesus. Mighty name of Jesus. Satan will have to flee. Oh, tell me who can
see? our plans, God. We give you our future, God. And we give you everything that concerns us. Hallelujah. 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 Pour me out. Pour me out. All I am is
come out to be here. And I'm thankful Pastor He, I love so much. And I love you all. And I pray that you will receive what the Lord has. This message, you know, we got four series as I just did. We had a week revival. And so I'm going to condense it the best I can and give you the meaty parts of it. True fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ. True fellowship with the Lord Jesus. Father, I thank you for utterance in the Holy Ghost to speak boldly the word of God. My heart's desire is your people have listening ears. They'll have hearts that will understand, eyes that will see, ears that will hear to do what you say, Lord. And Father, that you would open the eyes of our spirit man, that we will know the hope of your calling and the riches of the glory of your inheritance in the saints. Lord, I pray that every person listening will be doers of your word and not hearers only. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Open your Bibles. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 8 and 9. First of all, I want to read this in the NIV. In verse 8, it says, God will keep you strong to the very end. God will keep you strong to the very end. Then you will be without blame on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ returns. God is faithful. He has chosen you to share life with his son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Your fellowship is sharing Jesus' life, not yours. Amen. Give me the King James. Who shall also confirm you unto the end that you may be blameless in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 9. God is faithful. Now you want to find God's faithfulness? This is where you'll find it. By whom you were called unto the fellowship of his son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. You have the Amplified Bible? Okay, give me the Amplified. Let me read it in the Amplified. And he will establish you to the end. Listen to he will. So your main job as a Christian, a true Christian, is to stay hooked up with Jesus where he is always teaching you through the Holy Spirit and showing you how to stay in his strength all day. He will establish you to the end, keep you steadfast, give you strength. He'll guarantee your vindication. He will be your warrant against all accusation or indictment. So you will be guiltless and irreproachable in the day of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah. God is faithful. Yes, yes. But listen where he's faithful at. Because a lot of people say he's faithful. They don't even know. They don't even know what they mean. He's faithful in Jesus. Yes. He's faithful in your fellowship with Jesus. Listen what that means. Therefore, God is faithful, reliable, trustworthy, and therefore ever true to his promise. He can be depended upon. By him you were called into this companionship and participation with his son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Now the greatest faith statements in the Bible is in John 2 verse 5. Mary said this to the servants, whatever Jesus say, do it. You'll never hear a greater faith statement than that. People think faith is getting something, but really faith is hearing Jesus
believing and speaking what he say and doing what he tell you to do, producing him and not producing you, producing his life, his wisdom, his grace, his strength, not producing you. And so a true fellowship with Jesus is in embracing and living in what he is. This is the life you've been called to live in, the life Christ lived on earth. He didn't pay nobody back. He never, they called him every name in the book. He never said nothing back. And Jesus lived on this earth as a man with God inside of him, and so that we would see and know that it could be done, and for Jesus to show us how to do it step by step. Gee, you ready to suffer? You have not died. You'll never find God's will. You'll never find God's will if you're not willing to suffer your flesh, doing what it wants. As in 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 1. Turn to me that, brother Derek. First, I just want to read you this, 1 through 3. For as much then as Christ has suffered for us in the flesh, arm yourselves likewise with the same mind. For he have suffered in the flesh, have ceased from sin. And do you know what you cease from when you suffer? You have ceased from unbelief in him, that he no longer should live the rest of his time in the flesh to the lust of men, but to the will of God. Amen. For the time past of our life may suffice us to have wrought the will of the Gentiles when we walked in lasciviousness, lust, excess, around, reveling, all that stuff. But until you are ready to do what Jesus tell you to do, you'll never fulfill the will of God, the will of love, because God is love and love is Jesus on the cross. And so he wants us participating. Jesus said this in John chapter 15, verse 12. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. This on, you know, did y'all know this is the commandment that God gave us through Christ? We don't have a commandment to love God with our heart, soul, and mind, and strength, and to love our neighbor as ourselves. Those commandments hang on laws and prophets. And there's no Jesus in them to show us how. And if they was for us, what did he give a new commandment for? No, John 15, verse 3. Jesus said, this is my commandment. In Matthew 22, all he was doing was answering a question with one of the lawyers who was tempting him, asking, which of the commandments in the law is the greatest? He wasn't teaching the church to live mad. That was wrote to spiritual dead people, the Jews who were in the law. And it's not bad. Matter of fact, when you live in Jesus' love, you will fulfill loving God and loving one another as Christ loved you. This commandment demands faith. Loving God with your heart, soul, and mind don't demand no faith. Galatians 3:12 say the law is not of faith. The law don't rest on faith. The law don't require faith. And the law don't have nothing to do with him loving you. And you believe how he loved you. The law don't have nothing to do with that. This commandment demands you to have to believe how he loved you on the cross and then go live that love toward one another. Never producing you and me. We don't get to come out. When you love your neighbors yourself and you and your wife had a spat that night, you got to bring out how you feel according to what you done been through. When you love like Jesus, ain't no you. You'll never get to come out. You don't get to come out. You don't get to go off. You don't get to have moods. There are no moods in Jesus' love. You don't get to have a stress day. They're not in his love. You don't get to be depressed no more. They're not in his love. You don't get to go live any kind of way because it's not in his love. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. And then Jesus said, greater love have no man than this, than a man lay down his life for his friends. Verse 13. Now I want you to get this, what Jesus is saying here. Give me verse 13, Mr. Daly. No. 15:13. Greater love had no man in this than a man lay down his life for his friends. He's telling you, you ain't never gonna find nothing greater, no greater love ever than this, than what he did on the cross for us. It ain't gonna never happen. So this is the greatest. And when you love your neighbors yourself, listen carefully, now so you can get the revelation of this, and then you know how to go share. There's no forgiveness in those commandments. There's none of God's power to show you how to do it. Jesus is the only man that ever fulfilled the law. And this is how Jesus fulfilled the law. In John 15, verse 9, as the Father loved me, so have I loved you. Continue ye in my love. He believed how God loved him, and then he spoke what he heard the Father say, did what he saw the Father do. He produced God in every aspect. Never get no entry to his own thoughts. And lived a perfect life only because of two things. One, he didn't do nothing of himself. Number two, in John 14, verse 10, Jesus said, believest thou not that I'm in the Father and the Father in me? Where's God at? In Jesus. Where's Jesus at? In the Father. Where's the Father at? In Jesus. But where's Jesus at? But where's the Father at? In Jesus. Now here's the question. What does that mean? Here's what it means. Jesus said, the words that I speak unto you, I speak not of myself, but the Father that dwelleth in me, he doeth the works. Saints, people talk about themselves all the time, what they going through. And it's not Jesus dwelling in you unless you say it what he say. So people way off in this. They think they can fellowship with Jesus and walk in darkness. What happened is this. See, Jesus said, as the Father loved me, so have I loved you. Continue in my love. Verse 10, Jesus said, if you keep my commandments, see my commandments, you're going to stay in my love. The law of commandments, love God was talking about, they ain't going to keep you in Jesus' love. Love your neighbors yourself, ain't going to keep you in Jesus' love. It ain't. And no Jew can live this. Jesus said, you've heard it's been said, thou shalt love thy neighbor, hate thy enemy. But I say that you love your enemy. Man, they thought you were crazy. But he gives you the new nature. Then he shows you how to do it, then gives you the Holy Spirit, and then teaches you how to live this every day. Listen. If you're going to follow Jesus, none of your strength is going to ever mean nothing. He don't need you. He just needs you to cooperate with him. He needs you to bow down. He needs you to shut up. He needs you to quit thinking. He needs you to quit feeling. He needs you to quit looking at what this looked like and look at him. He said, if you keep my commandments, you shall abide in my love. Watch this. Even as I kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. What? What do you mean? What was God's commandments? As the Father loved him, he loved us. What's our commandment? As he loved me, I love you. If you live in this, you'll never break none of the 10 or the 1,000 that he got. You'll never break them. You'll never go to bed with another man's wife. You won't steal from nobody. If you love like Jesus, the Spirit won't let you. For when you are led by the love of God, which is the Holy Ghost shed around your heart, when you are led by the love of God, there is no laws that need to be in front of you. It's wrote in you not to do that. And in the Ten Commandments, ain't no do not be depressed. This will keep you from being depressed. do not stress. That wasn't in there. There's a lot of worried people, man, that was trying to keep the Ten Commandments. Then verse 11, Jesus said, these things have I spoken of you, that my joy might remain in you and that your joy might be Jesus. So Jesus, in your fellowship with him, got to speak something to you daily that you speak him, so his joy can keep your joy full. You ought to be able to go to him any time of the day and get your joy refilled. Any time of the day. You ought to be able to go without a credit card and get your joy filled up at no cost. His joy costs zero. Look at verse 12. Now, this is my commandment, that you love one another as I love you. Verse 13. Greater love have no man than this. He said, you can't go nowhere else and find this greater than a man laid down his life for his friends. Then, this is why I read all that to get to this. You are my friend. Everybody in Jesus' friend. If you do whatsoever I command you. Now, when you in fellowship with Jesus, you become his friend. When you in fellowship with Jesus, everything the Father gave him, you have access to. And everything he commands you, you do. You don't get to have no days where you have a fit and you just keep on whining. He tell you, shut up, stop it. I mean, if Jesus could, he would come down and say, then I tell you, stop it. Thank you. I tell you, you want to shake people. And say, that's not it. That's not Jesus. And so, saints, when you're fellowshipping with Jesus, the Son of God, here's one thing I want to hit tonight. There's no darkness in him at all. Now we need to go over this darkness thing. We need to go over the world. What in the world is darkness? Depression, lack, worry, stress, frustrated, irritated. This bothering me. I don't know what to do. I ain't got enough money. This is bothering me. You get on my nerve. Pastor, you don't understand what I've been through. I don't have to. I understand Jesus. Why I got to understand what you're going through? God done used me to help all kinds of people, rapists and people, man, done been doing crazy things. I told the Lord I didn't want to minister to them. I said, I'll do it on one condition on me. That you'll take hold of my tongue and give me wisdom what to tell. And he did, and I got cast the devil out of him, got him free. Matter of fact, it was 15 years later that the wife called me and told me that their husband been free ever since. It's been over 20 years now. Jesus said, you are my friend. Well, are you disclaiming his friendship? Are you just trying to act like you and him friends and buddies? And you don't do what he commands you? Come on now. Man, people come to church and act like they buddy with Jesus. Jesus don't even be talking to you. He don't even say nothing to you. Man, it's been 5 years since you heard from the Lord. Because he is not going to keep talking to you and you don't do what he say. Got to do what he say. Go to 1 John chapter 1, verse 1. Here we go. I love y'all. Amen. People in church playing games. They're real saints, ain't they? Real saints serious about this thing. People's lives are at stake, going to hell or heaven. Jesus told me years after 7 years in 1995, He said, you can't go back now. You crossed the line. He said, I've given you too much revelation and wisdom. He said, you'll die if you go back. Because it would shame his word and what I done taught people for 7 years if I went back. He wasn't going to let it happen. And I ain't going back. Just don't worry. I wasn't in no threat of going back. He just told me that. It put fear in me. And a good fear, good reverence. You know, don't play. In 96, the next year, my wife was in bondage and fear, and she wasn't submitted then. She got delivered in 2001. And I told her, I said, look, I'll take a $100 bill out of my wallet. I bet somebody will be with me for this $100 bill. You know, just trying to get her to be with me, you know. I got on my knees that night and prayed, and Jesus said, he said, if you go out and be with a prostitute, he said, I won't be to use you. Let's get scared, dog. I start crying. I said, but Lord, I was just playing. He said, no, Satan will take those words and bring them to pass. Whether you playing or not. So you get a lot of people in church. But I just was playing, and the devil be tearing them up. You can't play with your words. It's life and death in your tongue. You'll cause stuff to come that you don't even want to do, and it'll happen anyway because you playing. So I repented. I said, Lord, I'm so sorry for saying that. I pray the blood of Jesus get on them words, but Satan can't bring that to pass, and he never has. And I didn't want to do that, just being stupid. I got some sense now. And so Jesus taught me when I was, just a little year old in the Lord. And I've been up preaching all day and night, and it's 2:30, I'm tired. I was in the bed. This prostitute called me and said, I'm finna OD. You got the club scales. And I said, girl, why don't you wait till about 9 o'clock? She said, I'll be dead by the day. I said, oh, you ain't gonna be dead. I'll see you in the morning, bro. It's 2:30. It's something to 3. I mean, as soon as I hung that phone up, this voice came through that ceiling. I anointed you with my anointing. I called you to help my people. Now you get up and go help her. I said, well, Lord, I'm tired. And it felt like I some lightning hit me. I felt like I've been asleep 2 days. I woke up with so much strength. Then I get on the interstate. I felt a strong urge to pray in tongues. So I'm praying in tongues. You know where we get that fast? that urgent praying? Man, I was in it. And I didn't know that man was going to put no gun out on me and cock it. And so I prayed all the way there. Well, she's in there in this hotel room with a pimp. And she had a syringe full of heroin. She finna die. And she was sitting there with it already in a vein. I went and pulled it out. I got ready to pray for her. And she said, the Lord Jesus said, no, don't pray for her here. Don't pray for her here. This is Satan's turf. You take on neutral ground. So I took over to my sister where we prayed for people and got to be free from devils all the time. There's a lot of stuff we don't know the Lord know. Some places he ain't even have you do no warfare. He'll have you where it's a place where we got more strength and more angels helping us than stuff sitting there fighting against us. And so, man, I grabbed her stuff, and she went out the door. I'm coming out, and dude come out of the bathroom. He just got through shooting some cocaine. I said, man, you need God. He said, no, you need God. And so, I said, all right, Lord Jesus, what I do? That man got the gun cocked on me. And when I said that down in my spirit, my mouth was not moving. All of a sudden, the Spirit of God came upon me. Same thing came on Israel. Israel didn't know how to fight. God's Spirit would come on them, they're going to whoop every nation. And these words came out of my mouth. Dude got that gun. I said, go!
God sent me here, and I'm not scared of you or that devil in you.
And when I said that, he started doing like this
and ran out the door. I stuck my chest out. I said, yeah, but I really want nothing.
What are you talking about, fellowship? They don't put my shitties on me overseas. They did all kind of stuff, man. I've been persecuted. I'm not bragging. I've just been persecuted. Paul talked about his persecution. Why can't I talk about mine? I've been spit it on. And one man got up in my face and was just talking real crazy to me. Ain't got God. I know how you should be in the world. I'm in a barber shop. What you do, Prescott? Jesus said, get on your knees and worship me in the barber shop in the house. I got on my knees and worshiped him and said, Lord, I thank you for this persecution. Oh, I'm so grateful. Oh, Lord, I'll take this for you. I love you. I'm so thankful. I'm so thankful, Lord. I'll go through whatever for you. Listen, that man came back and attacked me again. I said, thus saith the Lord. You're going to get hurt messing with God's prophet. And he did. He had surgery. He broke his neck. Ended up getting saved. Fell in love with me. And hugged me every time he see me. So glad to see. He in church over me in fellowship now. Because I got on my knees and worshiped and took that persecution. Watch this. What is that? Fellowship. You ain't going to make it, man. You ain't going to make it through that persecution if you don't be in that fellowship. Because he got to tell you what to do. A lot of people ain't even ready for no persecution. They ain't even got there for that. You still trying to get over the devil. Listen. John and Pete and James had personal experience with Jesus for 3.5 years. Paul came along and had revelation of things that they didn't have revelation of. They had revelation of things that Paul didn't have revelation of. Holy Ghost made it all together for us as Christians. Now listen carefully to this. 1 John 1:1. That which was from the beginning, which we've heard, we've seen with our eyes, we have looked upon, our hands have handled of the word of life. You see what they call Jesus? They didn't call Jesus Jesus. You know what they call him? The word of life. Why don't we call him the word of life? See, they knew Jesus, what he said and did. Jesus, what he said and did. Hold your spot right there. Look at John chapter 16, verse 27. Listen to this. Jesus said, this red word, John 16, 27. Jesus said, as the Father, for the Father himself loveth me because, for the Father himself loveth you because. Now, wait a minute. You believe God loves you? Okay, that's good. But can you tell me why you believe that? No. Why don't we read it? And then they let Jesus tell us. Because Jesus said, because you love me and believe I came out from God. And man, people this day, they ain't follow Jesus' teachings and words and commandments. And so the church as a whole, they don't have none of these insights. They just don't. I've never heard none of this stuff preached ever. For the Father himself loveth you. Two conditions. Because you love who he sent, and you know who he sent, where he came from. Why is this so important? So you will never question him when you read something or he say something to you. I'm on my knees, and the Lord said, I want you to go to Grenada, West Indies. I said, all right, Lord, I'll go on one condition only. I'm on my knees. I said, there's the only condition I'll go, Lord. If you don't give me this, I won't go. So we're in a partnership. I said that you guarantee, you say out of your mouth, you'll bring me home safely. And this voice said, I will. I said, all right, what do you want me to do? He said, I want you to go to the ghetto. Now, I don't know what no ghetto is over there. I get over there, all I can think about is ghetto. So the ladies, they done prepared food for us. They got all these schools and all these places they want me to go preach. And I said, well, where is the ghetto at? Everybody got quiet. They act like that little bugger man showed up. Oh, Evangelist Scales. Oh, it's dangerous. When they said it was a place they called ghetto, I thought I got pregnant. Something leaped up in me, man. I got so much joy. I said, that's it. That's the place. That's where God want me to go. Do you know they dropped me off by myself and left me over there? I gotta go all the way in this little thing. Back at them huts, the sewage is outside. Little tent by ten. and they lived in real poverty. And it's stuck back there. And they gone. They drove off. Left me there by myself. But I ain't by myself. And they got this God over there named Diana. And they did not like me talking about Jesus. And so I said, is any of y'all sick? And the tallest guy there, he said, man, I injured my back. I said, oh, here it is. I said, listen, I'm going to pray for you. If Jesus don't hear you, y'all, I'm a false prophet. Y'all don't listen to nothing I say. And so I went over and laid hands on, prayed for him. Jesus healed him. And then I began to pray for some other men. And all of a sudden, here come this guy with this big old long machete. He cut grass with it. Cut your head off one lick. Stop that preaching that Jesus. Or I'm going to cut your head off. I told the Lord, this is 92. I told the Lord, I said, the Lord, he about 7-8 feet from me. I said, the Lord, you know I played point guard in high school. I'm going to do a fast break out of here if they don't got to get too close. And he kept coming. And the Spirit of the Lord came on. Man, Israel would be scared and the Spirit come on. They fight like lions. And the Spirit of the Lord came on. I said, God sent me here. And I'm not scared of you or that devil in you. And man, he started shaking like that. I said, whoa! And threw a little orange at me and ran. And then his buddies, they were getting ready to game. But the big guy that got healed was the strongest. He said, y'all better not touch him. My back got healed when he prayed. So I found out what kind of favorite food they like. So I go anywhere the Lord tell me to go. So we made a big pot of their favorite food over there. And we all ate with our hands. Yeah. And he will. Everybody. They wouldn't have liked the Pharisees. Because you couldn't wash your hands back then. I asked God to bless it, and that was the end of it. He blessed it. Amen. And then I couldn't let them eat and sit there and be scared something going to happen to me. I said, God bless his water. Never got sick. Matter of fact, they gave us all this, what's that spray? Off? Yeah, off. Oh, no, I turn it off. I don't put none on. But everybody brought cans of bugs. Over. Man, bugs bit people over there that had off on thousands of spots. But I'm in fellowship with Jesus. But listen, I got on my knees. I said, Lord, as soon as they said, you need cans or off, I got on my knees. I said, Lord, Will you protect my body from all them bugs? I don't want to wear that. That's something sticky. I don't want to wear that. I'm going to trust you to protect me. Listen, I got 2 bites the whole trip. Everybody else had hundreds and thousands of them. And the 2 that bit me, both of them died. I don't know why they bust through that. Amen. And so I'm over there, we get to eating. And this little boy came up. He said, "Preacher, please come with me, come with me, come." He will part me. I said, "Man, you keep taking me up in the mouth." I said, "Man, well, where are you taking me?" And then the word of the Lord came up. "But Lord, you promised you bring home safely." So I got peace to go with him. And these guys on crack. And they was on their last. I said, "Hold it, hold it. You don't never want to bother you when you take your last hit of crack. Because you get real angry, real mean. Because you ain't got no more dough." And I said, "Listen, I will buy both of y'all some more drugs if I pray and God don't change y'all." They said, "All right." So I lift my hands up to heaven and begin to pray. And I started telling God that he had delivered me. That I knew he had the power. Could have set me free like that. And that glory and power got filled. And they threw that dope away. I didn't even buy no dope. They threw their pipe away. Right in the middle of the prayer. What is that? Fellowship. People have made Christianity hard. Gotta beg God. And I've never been late on bills. Never paid interest on credit cards. Boy, I sure paid some things off on the last day. And I had to trust him. I don't never have it. I had to trust him. And I've never seen him not come through once. Listen. They saw Jesus as the word of life. How do you see it? Do you see him with the words that come from the Father that produce the quality that of life that God himself is? I don't believe nobody could come in here and rob us. They figure Monday, Sunday, Runday, and let up on Sita in the name. Man, they finna get barbecued. Man, you can't just come up wrong, me. What? I'm finna ask you, what's your God name? What is that? Because I'm gonna make him run into man. Let's see who wins. Man, the devil said, "We're gonna break in your house years ago." Ooh, y'all ever had those spooky devils in your house telling you, you know, somebody gonna bring it? I went and locked the door. I said, "I'll cast you out of them and get them saved if they come in here." Put that gun on the table. Put that knife down in Jesus' name. Son, I'm gonna preach to you. I tell you, the church is so scary. Oh, I tell you, the world is getting so bad. And I'll be going around saying, "God is manifesting more glory." If God be for us, what a world can be against him. Is he really who he say he is? Can he do what he say he can do? He can't take care of his children. Ain't no man supposed to be to rape none of y'all women. Devil, take your hand off me in Jesus' name. But that devil got to stop. Amen. Hallelujah. He'll be the one calling 911. It was a lady, man, she 90 years old. Dude done stuck her up. You know, she couldn't move fast. She in Walmart. He done watched her go out to a car. And then he done jumped in with the gun, poking it in her side. Said, "Grandmama, give me that money or you gonna die." She said, "Young man, I've already done died years ago. Said, if you shoot me, said, I'm just gonna go to heaven. You the one gonna go to hell. And when she got through with him, he was crying. He gave her the gun. Didn't want her to have her money. She bought him something to eat. Gave him a ride. You better not mess with those people that know the Lord. Her best gay, it ain't no fear in love. Y'all have read the scripture, perfect love do what? You ever study what perfect love means? Huh? Perfect love in the Greek is his love for you on the cross. His love for you will cast out fear. His love for you will deliver you. His love for you will keep you. His love for you will heal you. His love for you will peace you. His love for you will joy you. His love for you will give you strength. His love for you will keep you strong. His love for you will cast out every fear and tormented thought. What he did for you on the cross. He's got to love you first. They know you love him first. You ain't die. He gonna love him first and you didn't die. He died. Now watch. Go back 1 John 1:1. Now watch it, that's gonna get yummy. Gonna get yummy. I'll pick it back up tomorrow, but I gotta finish this. That which is from the beginning, which we've heard, which we've seen with our eyes, which we looked up on, our hands have handled the word of life. And then listen to me. I've been handling this word of life 29 years now. What Jesus teach, what Jesus say, what Jesus do. I don't accept nothing else in life, y'all. I don't from nobody. You don't bring me, Jesus taught this. You don't bring me. Most Christians, I mean real believers, really born again, really got the Holy Spirit, don't even talk Jesus' language every day. They don't talk the red words. They just don't do it. They ain't been taught to do it. They spend more time trying to read the Bible in the year. I ain't finna spend time trying to read no Bible in no year. I want to learn about Jesus more and more. Did you know, can I give y'all a secret? This is a secret. Jesus taught us to follow him. Sure, we can learn from Old Testament. I love Old Testament. I learn from it, but I don't follow it. I don't follow nothing back. I learn from it. I follow Christ. I don't follow nothing else. Why? Jesus didn't tell you to follow nothing else. People have made up stuff. They ain't even in the Bible. Look at verse 2 here. Look. Now you're going to get it in a minute. For the life was manifested. John said, we seen it. We bear witness. We show unto you that eternal life, which was with the Father and was manifested unto us. Verse 3. I'm going to keep going. That which we have seen and heard, declare we unto you. John said, what we done seen and what we heard, we declare to you. Now watch this. That you also may have fellowship with us. And truly our fellowship is with the Father and with his Son, Jesus Christ. Have Jesus really, really, really introduced you to the Father? Has he taught you about the Father? Has he shown you how to go in the throne to the Father and get you back there in the Holy of Holies and really get requests known and done every single time? Or do you just be praying? Do you really understand that when Jesus died and rose from the dead, that veil was rent? And now, through the blood of Jesus, we have access to enter that Holy of Holies through the blood of the Lamb. We can get back there and get anything God gave Jesus without begging for it. Our fellowship with the Father and Son Jesus Christ. Listen, look at this. This is going to start some of y'all, but I love you. I gotta tell the truth. I ain't upset for the Lord. He ain't gonna be upset at me. Verse 4. And these things write we unto you. And your joy may be full. You ever have a going through a little down there, read 1 John chapter 1, 1 John chapter 2, 1 John chapter 3, 1 John chapter 4, 1 John chapter 5, 2 John, 3 John. You owe your joy. This stuff was wrote so yo and my joy will be fuller. That's why devils don't like 1 John chapter 1, because these teachers on TV teaching. I'm not naming nobody, but I'm going to tear their doctrine up. They teaching 1 John chapter 1 is rotating Gnostics. That you don't have to confess your sins because you're already forgiven. Well, do you have to believe the Lord to heal you? Didn't Jesus provide healing for you on the cross? Do you have to believe that? Why call for the elders of the church? You're already healed. Do you have to ask him to deliver you? Ain't you already provided deliverance? But do you have to ask? Well, then why if you see it, you ain't got to ask? You got to ask for anything else? He said, well, things whatever you desire when you pray, believe that you receive and you'll help. So what they're doing is disregarding the doctrine of Christ. They're disregarding his doctrine. And a lot of people go to church do it. Can I read some of y'all what Jesus said real quick before we get through it? In John chapter 5, verse 23 and 24. Come on, Miss Derek. John 5, 23, Jesus said that you will honor the Son, that all men will honor the Son even as they honor the Father. Now, how do you honor the Father? You have to honor his words. When the devil tempted Jesus, he said, no. He said, I'm going to honor God, which means serve him. And him only shall I serve. So when you really worship the Lord in spirit and in truth, it's serving his words. You serving him when you honor his words. And Jesus said in John 15, verse 8, that y'all come to honor me with your lips, but your heart and reverence and respect for my words is far from you. But you honor me talking this all day. A lot of people talk, they talk a good talk, a good speech talk, but they don't do a good walk talk. That all men should honor me, even as they honor the Son. See, honor his word. He that honoreth not the Son honoreth not the Father that sent him. Now verse 24 is the key. Verily, verily, I say unto you, Jesus said, listen, this is the gospel. Y'all. He that heareth my words and believe that this is God, believe on him. Look what he said. Believe on him that sent me. You already have the words of the quality that produce God for your situation. You already got them. If you hear Jesus, you already got the answer. Jesus said, he that heareth my word and believeth on this is God who sent me. He said, if you believe what I say is really God, you already have that quality of life that'll defeat anything down here to get in the way. And you will not come into condemnation, but you will pass from what God ain't to what God is in Jesus. Now, what's the key to this? Tell me, fellowship, what's the key to fellowship? You got to hear him and then go do what he tell you and speak what he tell you and do what he tell you. The rest of this stuff in John, all people not in fellowship with the Lord. Go to 2 John, verse 9, just one chapter, a very powerful chapter. Give me the Amplified Bible, Josh. Whoever transcribed, listen, John understood these truths from Jesus. Transgress means you are in sin if you don't follow what Jesus said. Whoever transgresses sins and abides not in the doctrine of Christ, teaching of Christ, have not God. A lot of statements I'll be listening, because the Lord's talking, I'll be listening to TV. I say, that ain't God. That not God. Thank God they said something that was God. But I mean, if you don't know this, you don't know that all of it's tearing you up. Because you lifted man up instead of lifting up Jesus. You're going to lift him up and his teaching. You want to make sure it's studied, that what they're telling you, you can read it. Yes. Nobody want to hear what you think. But he that abideth in the doctrine of Christ, they walked with him. They saw the power that was on his words. He had both the Father and the Son. That John got this from Jesus. Listen to the Amplified Bible. Anyone who runs on the head of God does not abide in the doctrine of Christ. Some of y'all don't never quote Jesus' words. Who is not content with what Jesus taught does not have God. But he who continues to live in the doctrine and teachings of Christ does have God. He have both the Father and the Son. Why you have the Father and the Son? Because the words that came from Jesus' lips was God. And the letters got to line up with the red words, not you make a doctrine out of the letters. Everything got to line up with Jesus. And the cross, everything. I go back now to 1 John. Now you'll see it, 1 John 1, 4. John said, these things write we unto you, that your joy may be full. Now listen carefully to the statement I'm going to make. It's a very true statement. When you don't have joy, Jesus ain't no way around you. And you know religion will tell you the Lord's still working. But he ain't working. Because in his presence is fullness of joy. You can't get it in presence and come out sad. You can't get it in presence and come out depressed. You can't get it in his presence and come out weary. Not in his presence. And Jesus just walking down. Jesus just walking down the street. He's walking down the street while Atlanta watching. He walking down the street. Zacchaeus. That sycamore tree. We come into your house to have dinner tonight. And they start murmuring. No, Jesus, no dude is a tax collector. He done been taking people money. Jesus said in the word that he was a son of Abraham. And when Jesus brought that presence into Zacchaeus' house, he said, Lord, that they didn't even talk to him about nothing he been doing. And he just got in his presence. Said, I'm going to give back fourfold. I'm going to give back everything I done took. And I'm going to straighten up how I've been acting. All you got to do is get around him. You will straighten up. Yeah. Woo! Ain't nobody got to do no lot of preaching to you. Hang out with Jesus. And that presence will fill you with joy. You can't get in his presence and get back up and you still sad. You ain't been with him. You been with another Jesus. You ain't been with the Jesus in the Bible. Because in his presence, come on, talk to me, y'all. Is fullness, not a little bit. Be having religion. I've been trying to talk this stuff. Don't even have no joy. I said, you just don't know what I've been through. I said, well, you need to go through Jesus. Well, I've been praying, huh? No, he ain't answering you. You prayed, but you weren't in his presence. Verse 5. Now, this is what the Lord told me to teach y'all tonight. So I got 7-8 minutes. And I'll pick back up tomorrow. This then is the message we heard from Jesus. This is what John's teaching. We heard this straight from Jesus. That God is light. And in him is no darkness. Now people think God got darkness. God got wrath. But it's letting you reap what you sow, but he's not getting you. He's just a great righteous judge. And he hands out sentences based on the laws that are broke. God did not curse Adam and Eve. Their sins cursed them. God just told them what the curse was because they broke his word. And so man, I'm going to tell you, if you stay weary, you have devils. You're devils. You done put you on a praise song. You better dance around your house. You'll run them out if you start praising the Lord with some joy. One thing devils can never stand is joy unspeakable, full of glory. You might not even have the wisdom, but if you will find that joy, them devils will be quaking, trying to get away from you. They hate joy. Some of y'all need a hit tonight. Joy. You know, I picked my son up from school when he was in high school. I said, son, how you doing? Oh, Dad, I'm doing great. I said, well, tell your face, because he don't know it. You know, some of y'all face need a hit. Y'all do. You need a hit of joy tonight, man. You need something to just spurt you up. Something in the Holy Ghost. Joy in the Holy Ghost. God ain't got no sad people down here on earth. Not who's fellowshipping with him.
Well, you just, you know, something different about you. You're always happy.
No, I'm always in fellowship. This is a message we heard of him and declare to you that God is light. And in him, watch this, it's no depression, no worry, no distress, no anxiety. Let me tell you, I love my grandma. As much or more as you love Gary. I'm talking about this woman prayed for me when nobody else prayed for me. And she loved me when nobody else loved me. She was there for me when I was 7 years old and took me in and they took care of me. And she loved me and kissed me every day. And she was special. And I lost my dog. And the first time something died around me in 2012. I said, and I kept coming home. To get it off, I couldn't get it off. So I went to Jesus and said, Lord, I can't get this off. Because if I can't speak to it and get peace and joy, I got to go to him. Yes. I need some more instructions. Yes, and I'm in the shower. I said, Lord, I'm struggling with this. I don't know how to get this off of me. My dog, I said, my dog died around me. And Jesus started crying. I went in a vision. He's crying. I said, Lord, when you cry, I'm going to cry too if you cry. And he said, I'm getting ready to be separated from many of my creation. And he said, I'm very sad about that. I said, well, Lord Jesus, what are you doing? How do you make it through that? What are you saying? And you go, he said, I always look at how I loved them on the cross. And that's my joy. You remember that? Y'all remember that in the Bible? The Bible said, looking unto Jesus. Come on, Wally, the author and finisher of the faith. Who for the joy that was set before me endured the cross. Oh, God put some joy there. You got to have some joy if you want something. Okay, so that's why he said, when you get persecuted, rejoice and be exceedingly glad because you need some joy in that moment. And so Jesus asked me, said, did you love your dog? I said, yeah, Lord, I did everything for that dog. Man, we love that dog to the end. He said, that's your comfort. I said, what? I thought I needed to be comfort. No. He said, your comfort is you love them to the end. Yeah. And then he said this to me. He said, now do your grandmama likewise. She went home 2 years later. I had so much joy because I loved her. You know you loved him. You know you loved him. Your comfort is you loved them. You was there for them to the end. That is your comfort and your joy. Yes. Not to think about what you're missing. Yes. I don't miss my grandmama. I miss buying her groceries. You know, I went over there and bought her groceries for 18 years. I had joy, man. I preached a funeral. I had so much joy. I was dancing and shouting and praising God. Then I watched people. Oh, they just so depressed. Act like it's the end of the world. You can't fix it. Your comfort is you loved them.
Yes.
That'll bring you joy. and bring you joy if you think about how you loved her. My grandma went home and I just loved her. Oh, I was so happy she was in heaven. She told me for years, 20-some years, she said, "Grandson, I'm ready. When the Lord get ready, I'm ready to go home." I said, "Mom's kid, are you sure?" "Oh, I know that I know where I'm going." You get them grandma, they ain't playing, man. Their house is in order. I mean, your house in order, man, is. Yeah, some people ain't ready. Now watch this, let me close. We declare you God's light. Listen, he never can bring anything to you that ain't Jesus. He can't never bring nothing to you that ain't Jesus. God is light. In him is no darkness. Now look at verse 6. If we say that we have fellowship with him who is light and walk in darkness, we lie and do not the truth. You lying? I love the Lord. We didn't ask you, did you love the Lord? We asked you, where have you been fellowshipping with him? You ain't been worshiping him. You ain't been adoring him. You mad at him, maybe. Think he done took something special from you. The Lord too smart. He's a giver. He's a giver. We lie and do not the truth. If we walk in darkness, listen, when you down, you're walking in darkness. That is not the light. Let's close at John 8, verse 10, 11, and 12. Give me these last verses, Mr. Derek. And Jesus lifted up and said, "Saw none but the woman." He said to her, "Woman, where are thy accusers? Have no man condemned thee?" She said, "No man, Lord." And Jesus said to her, "Neither do I." See, Jesus got to get away, you away from every wrong voice so he can get you alone to tell you he loves you. And he's never out to get you for nothing you done did. And Jesus said, "Go and sin no more." Why? Because she could not follow him if she kept sinning. Nobody can follow Jesus who keeps sinning. And your sin, y'all, is the sin of unbelief. Not living in his joy every day. When you don't have no joy, you ain't been with Jesus. You have religion. A form of godliness that denies the power. You're struggling with something, it's darkness. And look at verse 12. When you get in fellowship, this lady got in fellowship with Jesus, and he said, "Go and sin no more." And she was gonna do that by using his words to tell the tempter, to tell the devil, and to tell those men who come back and hit on her again, who've been with her for years. Hey, Jesus told me to go and sin no more. Now you go on now, because I'm not doing that. Now the men, the devil, the temptation heard Jesus, not her. That's how I went all these years. My temptation keeps hearing Jesus. The tempter keeps hearing Jesus. The test and trial keep hearing Jesus. Whatever y'all going through, if you don't hear Jesus, you're struggling. Because you talking about how you feel and what this feel like. It's darkness. It's sin. Watch that. What? Verse 12. Then spake Jesus again unto them, saying, watch it. I'm the light of the world. I'm what God is and what God do in this earth. Now listen to these words in close. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness. You ain't gonna do it, man. You might have a darkness, But you can't walk in it if you follow Jesus, because the light of life is his words. They're going to come and tell you, stop that. Here I am. Here's what I do. I'm going to be with you. I'm going to be with you. You remember the Garden of Gethsemane? You know what Peter told Jesus? Now, Lord, I know all them going to deny you, but I ain't. You think Peter meant that? Yeah, he cut Judas off. He ready to die with Jesus. But Jesus said, you're going to deny me 3 times. And Jesus told his disciples, said, all y'all are going to be scattered. And y'all going to leave me. But I'm not alone. The Father will not leave me alone. That day when Jesus got on that cross, the Father left him alone. For a moment. Because Jesus said, Father, Father, why is that forsaken me? Why? Because when God laid our sins on Jesus, God turns in. He started looking at your darkness. I'm telling y'all, man, he did something about it in Jesus. And the joy of the Lord is your strength. And you don't have no strength if Jesus ain't giving you no joy. That he love you, that he with you. Now what in the world are you whining about in the kingdom of glory with you? Now if you want to get sad and depressed, do it if Jesus leads you. That way you ought to get real pitiful. But if he ain't left you, you ought to have joy and strength every day, rejoicing in him. Helped you come out of that, didn't I? Did I have that break off for you? Yeah. Man, you look like a different person. You do. You got peace now. It's just a peace all over you. But you didn't have that the first time I saw you, girl. But that word, so I get it. Get that out. That, goodbye. See you later. That's what I gotta do. You chop, 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 chop. I'm with you. Chop, do my will. Chop, you got a purpose to do. Chop, yeah, yeah. You got a purpose. Chop, stop it. Stop it, Wayne. Cause I'm with you. I got a purpose for you. I got a plan, and I want you to do my will. And I'll fill you with joy every day if you fellowship with him. You fellowship with devils, you're going to be miserable. You fellowship with Jesus, you're going to have joy. Your kids can knock over and break a plate. You can, and right then, Jesus can just feed you with joy. Praise the Lord. Car broke down. My car broke down. I had 2 flats. And Jesus said, I want you to get out and dance around the car. I said, Lord, it's 11:30. It's downtown Nashville. It's right down the bumper. Look at all these people. And I got out and danced around him. I was so full of joy. And then had the money, he fixed both my flats. If Christians will learn to rejoice in the midst of troubles, that our God have already made a way for us to come out of that, we'll be some happy tankers down here. And we will see the glory of God every day. Stand to your feet. Glory to God. Lift your hands up. Thank him for his word. Y'all come and get this out of the way. Amen. Come on, lift your hands up. Say, Lord, we thank you for your holy word. I'm going to pick it up tomorrow. I'll do the best I can. And I'm going to finish this chapter tomorrow. There's 10 verses. But I'm going to show you where Jesus will talk. John will talk about sin. If we say we've not sinned, that sin he's talking about, it's the sin of unbelief. You can't say you don't have no sin when your fellowship broke. You can't say that. You got to acknowledge, man, I'm wrong. He ain't. Ain't nothing wrong with him. Something wrong with me. So you can't say you don't have no sin when your fellowship's broke. You can't say I ain't did nothing wrong when your fellowship. When he ain't answering your prayers and filling you with joy every day, your fellowship's been broke. And it takes repentance to get that back. Real godly sorrow. And so then y'all need to come and get that right. get your fellowship back, right? He just don't talk to you like he used to talk to you. Now he don't do it. Why? Something wrong. You ain't spending time with him. You got your mind on something. You let worry or stress stay in your thinking. And you're not going to fellowship with him if you're thinking wrong. Because it steals your joy. And Jesus is all about joy. Be a good cheer. I've overcome the world. Gotta have joy. I'll be calling you with joy. Joy! Every day. I done had joy every day for 29 years. And if I did lose it, I'd repent and go hurry up and get it back. Well, he'd tell me what to speak and what to do, and I'd get it right back doing what he said. I won't tolerate troubles. I won't tolerate them. Anybody come here and need healing in your body? You might have been faith, but I'm anointed. That woman was in faith. If I touched the hem of his garment, before she had to get up, that's where that anointing was. That virtue came out of Jesus. A lot of people sit in church, I'll be saying, man, if they could get a touch of the anointing with their faith, they would be made whole. He said, daughter, thy faith that made thee whole. She had to get to that anointing. Did you know that if her faith just believed and didn't get to the anointing, she wouldn't have got it? I have to teach people, man, because the devil will tell you, oh, you're in faith, you don't need that anointing. That's not true. And then a lot of times people come up and they say, Pastor Ken, I'm already in faith. Say, will you just release that anointing? You speak the word over me, I'll be made whole. I've had people do that, have cancer. I said, ma'am, what do you need prayer about? She said, I don't need prayer about nothing. Just speak the word. Speak the word, I'll be healed of this cancer. And go back to the doctor, they can't fight. We had a lady in church. This new lady moved in town, didn't have nothing. We just started loving on her. And she prayed. About 6-7 months prayed. And they found spots on that baby. And she came up just crying. I mean, just I thought she thought we was in the millennium and at the end of time. I said, well, hold on. Jesus still here. She said, what? I said, Jesus. I said, I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna speak the life of Christ. Command those spots to be removed off that baby. She said, Josh, I didn't tell y'all this. She said, I go back on the 24th of July to get it checked again to see if I have to abort the baby. I said, oh no, you ain't doing that. And they called me yesterday. I forgot to tell y'all. They called me yesterday and told, no, Monday was 24th. That all the spots were gone. My doctor said, well, they took 2 x-rays because they couldn't believe that what they saw. We just spoke that. We didn't even pray for them. We just spoke and believed those things which I said. I just believed it would come to pass. That Jesus said, I'll have whatever I say if I don't doubt in my heart. You need fellowship with Jesus. Oh, you need to be in love with him more than you was in love with him last year. How do you get love with Jesus? Let me tell you, I prayed for 10 years for Jesus to teach me how to love him more. I just wanted to love him more. I didn't know how. And I prayed for 10 years. And then all of a sudden, listen, and for 10 years. And so I finally said, Lord, I don't want to be crying. Y'all ever cry? Y'all get over there with the Lord. Oh, Jesus. I love you. Y'all just tell me you love him and cry. Me too. Ain't it fun? Boy, tell you me right there. You know you're happy as you can be. You can't get in his presence. Oh, that's like good thing. You see the thing? What was I telling you about 10? What did I say? 10 years. I asked the Lord. I said, Lord, I prayed every day. I waste all my time praying for that. I said, why are you in
teach me how to love you more. And Jesus said, just real soft. He's so gentle. And he won't be ugly to you. Now, he put it false that when it's his will. He kept me on track all these years. He said, stop it. You know, he didn't talk to me nice. But when it's me missing it, he's so gentle and nice. And he asked me a question. He said, do you love your wife more? I said, oh, Lord, yes, about 10,000 times more. He said, that's how you love me more. How you love people more. Y'all better get that. It's a nugget. You ain't gonna grow in love if you don't grow in loving others as Christ loved you. Amen. I'm about to say it, man. Ain't nobody sick. Y'all got healed. That's how it is in my church. I go months and can't pray for nobody. We don't get no visitors. Hey, everybody well. Everybody, the whole church well. We got to say, is any sick among you? And they said, no. Hey, wonderful. Y'all lift your hands, thank God. Y'all don't know, give out of that. Y'all dismissed. We'll see y'all tomorrow night. 7 o'clock. Boy, I like that, man. That boy on that organ, be tearing that organ up. I love y'all. Have a blessed night. We'll see y'all tomorrow night, 7 o'clock. Thank y'all for coming out. I hope you got something out of that.